Hello guys, welcome to another video in the series of coding. Today we have with us the daily challenge problem of today on LeetCode. So it's called swapping notes in a linked list, and this is a fairly good problem. You're given the head of a linked list and an integer k. You have to return the head of the linked list after swapping the values of the kth node from the beginning and kth node from the end, and the list is one indexed. Okay, so basically if this is the linked list, let me zoom it out just a little bit less. So if this is the linked list, okay, then in this case what you have to do is, for example, you are swapping k is equal to 2 means at the second position from the beginning and from the end. So let me take the second position. So this is the second position from the beginning, this is the second position from the end. So you just swap these two positions and you get 4 and 2, right? So let's see the approach quickly. So this is the linked list that we have taken, and you have to basically swap 2 and 4, and final linked list will become 1, 4, and then 3, and then 2, and then 5. Because you have swapped 2 and 4. Why you have swapped 2 and 4? Because k is given 2 and the list is 1 index. Means index is starting from 1. So this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5. So you have to swap second index from the beginning, second index from the last. Second index from the last is this. Okay, and second index from the beginning is this. So you have to swap these two positions. Okay, so what will be the logic of this code? So basically they have given the hint to us, so we need not think more. Actually it's very good that they have given the hint to us. So they have said we can transform the linked list to an array and they should ease things up. Now after transforming to an array, it becomes easier swapping two integers and then rebuilding the linked list. So fairly simple. First let's just transform the linked list to an array. So let's do that. So let me first take list node star temp is equal to head. Okay, so the head node I am taking that, and I'm declaring another node temp and equating it to head. Okay, now what I can do is I can transform this linked list to an array. Transform in the sense, let me declare a vector. Okay, let me declare vector in, let me just call it v for short. So what I will do is while temp, that means while temp is not null, so while temp is not null, this loop will run, and it will run, let me just zoom it. Okay, so this loop will run, and what we have to do, temp equal to temps next. Why I am doing this? I am just transforming it to a vector. So what I will do now, I will say v dot pushback temps value. So each time I am pushing back the value of that particular node. Okay, so each time I am pushing back, first one will get pushed. Okay, so basically this was the vector one. Okay, this is the linked list 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So they have told us first make this, convert this, okay, into a vector. So I will declare a vector and I will convert it. So each time nodes will be dropped off. First I drop one, I push back one, I push back two, then I push back three, then I push back four, then I push back five. Okay, so I have converted this linked list, not converted in the sense I have just taken another vector and transformed, or in the sense helped this linked list by storing it in form of a vector. Okay, now I go to the next value. So now when it becomes null, it will stop, so all the values will be pushed. Now what I do after making it into an array, it is easy, we have to just swap. Okay, so how to swap? So what I will do is I will also do count plus plus each time, and I will declare int count equal to 0. Why I am doing this? I am doing this to get the size of the linked list. So this will give me the size of the linked list, so I will use my size now. That's why I have done this. So it will just give the size of the linked list, count will have size. So now what I will do, I have to swap. So let me declare a swap function. What I have to swap? I have to swap the index. Okay, suppose k is given 2. Okay, if k is given 2, then I have to swap index from the beginning to the second position. Okay, but in array, index is 0 indexed, right? Array, let me write it properly. So in array, the indexes are 0 index. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. But in linked list, the index are 1 index. So linked list index are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And array index. So linked list, the index which corresponds to 2 is going to correspond to index 1 in the array. Okay. So basically, let me give the first index that I have to swap in the array. Now I am swapping numbers in the array. So in array, what I will have to do is I will have to give k minus 1. Because my k is past 2, right? So from the beginning, k is 2. But in array, it is 1. So I will give, this is the first element. Okay, now from backside, I have to swap this index. From backside, second index. So in this, it is 3. Okay, so what is this 3? This is just size minus k. Okay, k is 2. Size is 5. 5 minus 2 is 3, right? 5 minus 2 is 3, size is 5, and k is given to us. So that is the next index. So size is just count. That's why we have used count. Count minus k. So this is the first index that I have to swap. This is the second index that I have to swap. In this example, it is 1 and 3. Okay. And now I will also pass the vector. So I'm just declaring an extra function just for convenience. It's not at all necessary. You can do it even simpler way. Okay. I will make void swap. So this is the function. I will use the function. So int I, int j. And I will pass the vector. I will pass the vector by reference. So I will do ampersand sign because I'm passing by reference. Means all the changes that I make here will be reflected here. Okay. Now I will just swap it. So how to swap two numbers in a vector? Very, very simple. Int temp is equal to I. Okay. Sorry. Int temp is equal to V of I. V of I is equal to V of j. And V of j is equal to temp. So V of j is equal to temp, right? So that's it. I would have swapped. Okay, now I have swapped the elements. Now I have to rebuild the linked list. So what I will do is I will rebuild the linked list in this linked list itself to save space. I will just rebuild in the linked list that is given to me itself. So how can I do that? I will just declare another list node, star temp2 equal to head, and I will do the same thing now, while temp2. Okay. So I have to rebuild all the elements now. So while temp2 is true, that means temp2 doesn't become equal to null. Okay, I will just rebuild the linked list. So temp2's val, so the value which the particular node is taking, is just equal to v of I. Now what is I? I will start from 0, int I is equal to 0, and I can keep incrementing I++. So what I'm doing, first element of the array goes back to the linked list. So now this is the array, right? This is the array that I have obtained after swapping these elements. Okay, after swapping these elements, there is some error with my eraser. Okay, anyway, so this is the array that I had built up, okay, from the linked list. Now, this is the array that I had built up. Now, I swapped these two elements. So this becomes 4, this becomes 2. I just gave the swap function. Now, I have to rebuild the linked list because I have to return in form of linked list. So, I rebuild the linked list. So, 1, 4, 3, 2, 5. Okay, I just rebuild the array to linked list. So from linked list, okay, from linked list 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this was my linked list. What I did, I just converted that to array. Just took another array and stored the values in some array. From this array, I did swapping elements because swapping is easier in array than in a linked list. Now from this array, I am swapping storing the values back in a linked list. Okay, that's it. So as simple as that. So now temp2's val is equal to v of I plus plus temp2 is equal to temp2's next. While it becomes null, it will itself exit. Okay, we need not worry. And then we can return temp2. Or we should return actually head because temp2 will become null. So there's no point of returning temp2. We should return head. So that's it. I hope that it will work. Let's just run and see if it's working. So it's working. And let's just submit and see if it's working for all the test cases. So it's an accepted solution. That's it. Thank you for being patient.